Hi, I'm Dave Tenney. I'm a product manager at Agilent Technologies, responsible for waveform generators. I'm going to show you some unique capabilities to our newest waveform generator, the 33500B series. We're going to show you a two-tone signal and then also additive noise. This is a very unique capability to this waveform generator. I'm going to begin with the first tone of the number one on a keypad. This is what it sounds like. Let's now add the second tone, which is at 1209 hertz. We do that with the modulation menu. There's a modulation type called sum. Within sum now, we can set the frequency of the second tone as well as the amplitude. So let's set the frequency, that's 1209 hertz. We'll set the amplitude at 100%. Now with this capability, you can actually set the amplitude at different levels to do other types of applications. Let's look at this on the oscilloscope. Now you can see the dual tone signal. This is what a typical one looks like. So we have the dual tone signal created now. Now let's put some additive noise onto here. We do that by using channel 2. We'll turn on the noise. The noise is set at 100 millivolts peak to peak. That's at about 10% of where the dual tone is. So let's leave it there to start with. Now the way we combine this is we go to the dual mode channel operation. We simply combine the two channels, and now I've added the noise to the dual tone in channel 1. So let's look again on the oscilloscope. And you can see just a little bit of noise on that waveform at this point. Now let's add, under the noise, let's increase the amplitude of that noise just to show you a little more clearly. Now I actually have the noise level up at about 70%. So now you can see that there's much more noise on this signal. So you have the ability to adjust the level of noise that's on your two-tone signal. Now let's listen to this dual tone with the noise. You'll notice that it, for us with our human hearing, it mostly sounds like a dual tone. However, electronic instruments are much more sensitive and are able to detect that noise. So this is a good example, particularly for the telecom industry, for testing your devices that need to listen for these tones and decode them.